I've made a copy of ODB 74, and I'm calling this one ODB 75 Invoice Part 3, Add Data. Before we can create our invoice, we need to have something to print out. And entering in some data will also give us a clear idea of what we have to work with and how it got there. I'll open up the customer form first, because we can't create an invoice if we don't have any customer data in the database. I'm working out of my house, and I'll say my first customer is Uncle Lou. He's trying to help me out, so he gives me some work. I'll type his name in, and his address, city, state, a postal code in the USA, we'll give a phone number, an email address, a website, and some notes that he's my first customer. Now notice in the notes, it's putting this in the center as a single line. I'm going to want to change that. So let's save the information. I'm going to close this. I don't need to save the changes. And now I'm going to reopen this in edit mode. We'll notice that our notes is overlapping the website field. It looks like that here, but that's not truly the case. If I zoom out a little bit, we see that it is properly proportioned. I'll hold down Control and click on the notes text box, because that's the one I want to change. Right click, Control, and I want to change a field down here at the bottom, this text type from single line to multi-line. That's good. I'll save my form. And let's stay in here and enter in the rest of the records. I'm going to click on the design mode on off. And we'll go to the next record. I'm going to zoom in so we can see a little better. And my company name is the Made Up Publishing Company. The address is 3925 Second Avenue. That will be in Salem, Kentucky. And this is all made up data I'm using as test data. That's in USA. The phone number is 555-9345. The email address, that email address will be journalistcontact@mup.com, website mup.com. And my notes, see now we're up in the upper left hand corner. And my notes are that my contact name there is Tom Block. Let's go on to the next record. This company's name is going to be The Big Computer Company at 2211 Sycamore Street, Greenville, Colorado, 61319. Country again, USA. Phone number 555-9876. The email address, that is going to be hrperson@bcc.com. The website is bcc.com. And my notes will be that my contact person there is Katie Smith. And I will save that record. I'm going to save the changes we made to this form and close it. I'll say yes, we'll save our changes. Now let's enter in the invoices themselves. I'm going to right click and edit this in case we need to make some changes. We'll already be in edit mode. I'm going to come down to the design mode on off and start entering my data. And the first thing I notice is my customer ID is screwed up. So let's fix that right now. I'm going to hold down Control and click on the Customer ID text box. Right-click, Control, and going down to the bottom, I notice that my drop-down is set to No. I'm going to set that to Yes. And I also want to hold down Control and click on the Customer ID label, because I don't want this to say Customer ID. I want this to say Customer. That's good. I'll close this. I'll save my changes. And let's go into entering the data. Our first field, invoice ID, that is auto-populated. Our first customer was Uncle Lou. And now let's enter the invoice date. We'll say this happened back in February. He was our first customer. So we'll say we sent him the invoice on February 28th. The status will be not paid, and the note will be my first customer. And again, we notice that the notes is in that single line. We'll change that, but there may be some other things we want to change. So I'll hold off a minute before I make any more changes. Now let's get into the tasks that we did for Uncle Lou. Coming down to the description, we converted three computers from Windows to Linux. We'll say he paid us $50 and also that he bought us a pizza. Now this task ID and invoice ID, we want to hide those. So we'll take care of that when we do the same thing with the notes for our invoice. I'm going to go back and add in the next description. We also added a Linux server to the network. We'll say that we charged him $35 for that. And again, he bought us a pizza. Now, if I click my next to go to the next record, it actually takes us down to the next description. We want to go to the next invoice. So I'm going to add in two buttons for the invoice. And then we're going to clean up our subform a little bit as well. So let's do that right now. Everything's saved. I'm going to go back into edit mode. Holding down Control and clicking on the notes text box. Right clicking, Control. We want to change this to multi-line. I'm going to change the amount owed in the formatting to be a currency. I'm going to close this for a minute. I want to right click and hide the invoice ID. I also want to hide the task ID. And let's see if I can make this box a little smaller. Okay, we got rid of our scroll bar, and that's what I was trying to do. The last thing we want to do here is add our buttons. Before I add the button, though, I want to open up the form navigator and make sure that I've got the main form selected, because I want to make sure that these buttons work for the main form. Now I'm going to add my button and add another one. Try and make these both the same size. So I'm going to open up the properties, change button 2 to be next record, and down in the action, change this to next record. Clicking on the other button, I want this one to be previous record. Prev record. And then down our action, previous record. Let's save this and go back into the data entry mode. We've got our first invoice created. Let's go to the next record. And this customer is going to be the made-up publishing company. we'll say that we invoiced them back in July. We'll say July 15th. The status is not paid. And our comment will be, this invoice is for all three articles submitted. Our first article is about LibreOffice Draw. And for that, we got $50. And we published in issue 107, April 2014. The next article is about LibreOffice Writer. Again, we got $50. And we published this one in issue 108, May 2014. And our last one, we wrote about LibreOffice Base. For that one, we got $75. And that one was published in June of 2014. We still have one more invoice to create. I'm clicking Next Record. And that one's going to be for the big computer company. We invoiced them on September, we'll say September 1st. Status is not paid. And that was for work completed in August. The description is, we worked on the data recovery project. For that, we got $1,500. And that was a fixed cost project. Now we've got all three of our invoices created. Let's take a look at how they're stored on the tables. Going to close this. Do I want to save? Yes. And on our customer tables, that's going to look pretty much how we expect. All the information under its proper title. On the invoice table, it doesn't make too much sense looking at this. We can see the invoice date. The status is either paid or not paid, which is that checkbox. They're all not paid. And then we've got notes about the invoice. Then we've got our tasks that we did. And that doesn't make too much sense by itself. We've got our description, amount paid, and the notes. And then we connect that to the invoice ID and then to our customer ID. And that will all make sense when we bring that all together. We'll create the report in the next video.